frame. There we go, then. Done everything. Oh, we still got a few more. Okay, we'll come back. Let's go. Verity Sands. Partly I'm thinking just to stay in this Prosperity Sands till we've done everything in the area, then move on. Go on. Makes sense. Makes sense to do.
A quiet space is the ideal stage for the shark to meditate and harness her pure potentiality.
Some bits and come back to them. Who knows, maybe we'll find them way out. There's a wee bit awkward.
Prosperity Sands features glittering white beaches fenced off for the sole enjoyment of the ultra rich, mega rich, and super rich.
Can we get in?
Seldom miss an opportunity to indulge in mindless, gratuitous slaughter.
Oh, hey.
What?
atavistic notions of their business in the future.
About being here is they don't seem to be chasing me. Off one by one. Down. But there's not. That's annoying. I can't just turn down the graphics.
Another shortcut begins.
Well, by Golden Shores, we got a shark that needs to be put away. Full shark, baby!
Thank you.
life expectancy is at half, thanks to its lifestyle choices and risky behavior. Sharks are Mother Nature's support to America's overcrowded coasts. Even half dead, the shark is still a potent menace to any and all.
Far away.
Anybody else see that? What is that?
Long, long.
Suffocating out today. Anybody got a good set of needle nose pliers?
With little fanfare, another bounty hunt comes to a close.
The beast of the fleet, Captain Robert Bruntlett.
The last guy.
Bounty for you in the Golden Shores area.
Thank you.
steps in as the conflict escalates.
Down to you, guys.
Another shark hunt draws to a...
The bull retreats to the grotto for refuge and quiet reflection.
The bull swings her tail like a whip. The hunter lashes out at its target with an extended tail fin.
This was...
As is the trend in other coastal towns, long stretches of Port Clovis's shoreline are now the exclusive domain of the wealthy.
Thanks to powerful risk assessment software, we now know that this was a wildly idiotic place to build vacation rooms. Fishing boats began as simple dugout canoes before evolving to brogans, bug eyes, skipjacks, and chape-chuffs. A day at the beach is a summer ritual that wouldn't be complete without plenty of sunshine, sandcastles, and sercarial dermatitis. Given the number of people who frequent the beach, it can be rationally assumed that a little human urine finds its way to the sea. Is the ideal stage for the shark to meditate and harness her pure potentiality.
Should have brought my fish finder. Well, everyone's going home empty-handed today. Coast Guard, we've been getting some major complaints about a shark near Cabana Breeze. The poor shark hunt. She gotta be somewhere out here.
Slippery as it is dead. This trawler, operated by Roger Cantrell, recently broke the state record for number of revocable commercial fishing offenses. Off a successful casino heist is made even harder when you drive off the road into the ocean and drown. The appetite of this shark is nearly insatiable. The battle is over, but the war goes on. Random mutations aren't random. They require large amounts of mutagens as a catalyst. Times faster in water. A fact beneficial to both hunter and prey. Clovis considered removing these naval mines after the war, but the city had already spent its annual budget booking a Nickelback cover band for the 4th of July. Oxygen needs, mahi-mahi must constantly swim to ventilate their gills. From the moment she's born, the shark's cold, expressionless eyes are constantly on the watch for food. This instantized protein makes a great between-meal supplement, giving the shark the energy she needs to put on serious bangs. Shark is a sort of super scavenger, completely lacking in what may be called dietary discrimination. While they appreciate human sacrifices, the eldritch gods of yore are seldom enthused about being summoned to Port Clovis. Mutagen 23 is certainly heating up the evolutionary arms race. Thank you. There is a very real risk of drowning while surfing, but at least you'll leave behind a cool-looking skeleton. The ocean is a fluid and fascinating world, always changing. Forever in motion. To look at the coast is to recognize that the boundary between sea and land is transitory, and that all life on Earth is just a cosmic accident. Sharks' propensity to clear the ocean of its assorted detritus is one of their most valuable functions. Have seen less than 5% of our oceans, which means there's still plenty of treasure out there for everybody. There would have been more protests surrounding Prosperity Sands were not the public already so numbed about ecological concerns in general. Constantly reminded of how man's intrusion has disrupted the fragile equilibrium of the marine world. Each year, North American offshore drilling rigs leak about 880,000 gallons of oil into the sea, leaving it for marine wildlife who know nothing about running a profitable energy company. Sharks have a habit of gobbling up anything that finds its way into the water. When it was discovered that their Stonehenge replica was astronomically misaligned, enraged Port Clovians threw it in the ocean.